A TSBVI outreach tutorial. APH Graphic Aid for Mathematics, aka Graph Board. Part 8, Graphing a Circle on the Coordinate Plane. Presented by Susan Osterhaus, a Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Math Consultant.
Okay, we're going to graph a circle now, and we're going to use our wire, one of our wires. Okay, so we're going to decide to graph a circle, and instead of this being more elementary circle, we're going to pretend that we're doing something called analytic geometry, where you're actually graphing the circle on the coordinate plane again. And we're going to pretend that this circle has the center at the origin, which means that's going to be, it's not going to actually be a point, because the circle, how we define a circle is, in this case, we are going to say that the circle has a radius of 4. So if we start at the origin and go in any direction 4 units, 1, 2, 3, 4, and place a point. And now we'll go, that particular one, we went to the left. Now we're going to go to the right, 1, 2, 3, 4. And notice I'm picking very nice distances of 4, not ones out like this, because it would be more difficult for me to count 4 that way diagonally. And then I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 up, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 down. And now I have what should be a circle if I connect the points correctly. Well, okay, I want a circle, right? Oh my goodness, what happened? I used a rubber band, and that looks like a diamond or a rhombus or a square. That does not look like a circle. Bad choice. So this is not what we want, because this is not really the point on there. It's the one that's 4 units out. Trying to sit here and hold this and make this look like a circle would kind of be a little bit counterproductive, especially if we're trying to take a digital picture. So, not a good choice. So, this is when we get the wire out, and what you do is, by the way, the students can do this much more easily than me. Somehow, they can find that little slot, and bottom line is you just put that right over your points, tighten it up a little bit. And now the students can recognize that it is a circle. And again, from the distance from the center of the circle to the circle itself is 4 all the way around. And that is a very good use of these wires. Now I will warn you, if you have some of the older wires, that this particular metal rusts very easily. So try to keep these in away from any moisture. Or as I do, sometimes I warn the students that to wash their hands after their use if they happen to get any rust on their hands from it, so that they're not getting it on their clothing. But anyway, other than that, the wires are very nice. Now, I will tell you something else, that when you get into larger circles, okay, let's go ahead and make the radius on this 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. I hope I counted right. I'll find out soon. Well, what's going to happen here? Okay, as I dodge a little bit over here to the left, I have to grab another wire. And my students came up with this. I said, oh my gosh, what are we, I do this all the time to my students. What are we gonna do? We can't graph this. So they managed to come up with, put another one. Now, let me see if I'm gonna be able to do this. So they put two together. And what, of course, they didn't like was the fact that this little thing sticks out. I'll show you what I'm talking about in a moment. But anyway, so they did like this. And they are now able to make a larger circle. Now, I happened to pick one that was nice, and there's not too much of a tail there. So I don't know if you can actually see that little bit of a tail where it's coming up. That one is very nice, and there's just a little bit of a tail over here, and that's only because I picked a circle with radius 8. I was crafty. But anyway, what my students say is that APH should include these little clippy things that would hold that, so that this little tail wouldn't stick out quite so much. So they have all kinds of great ideas as to how to change the APH product a bit. And by the way, if you have other changes, etc., please let me know. many of these things, my students and I, we have just decided to add to the parts and so forth. So if you come up with a great idea, please let me know, because again, this is one of my favorite things. So this is probably one of the best uses of the wires, is when you are having to graph circles. And you saw what happened with the rubber band, so I think that's something that you can all understand. And I presume if we wanted something bigger, we could even connect that third one and make an even larger circle. Probably that's why they give you three. Three is about it, otherwise you're gonna be off the frame of the graph. And that's how you graph circles.
This video continues in the TSBVI Outreach Tutorial Series, APH Graphic Aid for Mathematics. Look for other videos by Susan Osterhaus on Math for the Blind and Visually Impaired. APH is American Printing House for the Blind. A TSBVI Outreach Distance Learning Production. Executive Producers, William Daugherty, Superintendent. Cyril Miller, Outreach Director. Outreach Producers, Susan Osterhaus, Math Consultant. Mike Bicknell, Media Specialist. Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Programs. 1100 West 45th Street, Austin, Texas 78756 USA. Telephone 512-454-8631. Website www.tsbvi.edu. Video copyright TSBVI 2009. All rights reserved.